Hello and welcome back to PsyOps the Mindgate Conspiracy. And when we last of all the events once again took a turn for the weird, maybe also the worst incidentally, because I never imagined myself fighting some ghosts here in this game when I first picked it up. But regardless, for now we continue, and of course I'm replaying the first section of this particular area because, yeah, he was here shortly. There will be some friends waiting, and even Ghost Vision won't be revealing them. Because the General has control of all the fucking dudes around here. Okay. And more friends coming in, of course, as well. Mhm. Good divide. Get out of here. I know he's still around. So, that leaves us and this guy around here. Yeah, I probably have to. If I just shoot this fucking guy here. Just fucking shoot him. There we go. I've had enough of your friend, to be honest. Okay then, and of course, as you've seen, even with Ghost Vision, we cannot spot them because they immediately spawn in essentially. Oh, that's delightful. So can we even pick up some ammo because I threw these people over the terrace like an idiot. Okay. Alrighty then, so we return back to the door because it needs to be opened, I'm assuming, right? To install this psychotronic device on the satellite dish. Yeah, let's just stop questioning things in this game, frankly. Yeah, upper terrace, of course, it will directly connect to the uplink here somewhere. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, and remember that red thing? I guess what we need to be doing is to bring that item over here, that key combination, or the ancient key, or whatever they call it. So this will be difficult and also pretty tedious, because we're talking about the Havok physics engine, case in point. the existence of these objects sometimes prevents Nick from taking cover, for instance. You know, so there we have it. We need that, because this was also red, right? Indeed it was. Oh, is that an item we can put in our inventory? That's sad. But I think it will be useful upstairs. Yeah. But this is light, so it doesn't rain much side juice. Yes, I know there's double lifting in this game, but it's so unreliable. But there we have it. And of course the door doesn't open, and I cannot open the door if I'm carrying an item. So, but I think it's necessary up here. I guess we'll find out shortly. Yeah, so these things I cannot attack until they decide to attack me. So, what gives I guess? See, that's what I figured. Of course it's necessary. And yeah, there we have him again, or it, or whatever it may be. Okay, I don't think there are any supplies downstairs. We have to deal with these people in some capacity. Or at least this guy. Okay, but how are we doing this? I don't quite remember. Apparently they can sense my psi power. I'd rather fight them now than later. Ach, 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 ach. Of course, this bond is shit in behind me as well, so I have to do this entire section yet again. Oh man. Because if I press the continue button, guess where we are? Up here now, again. Oh man, you cannot be fucking serious with this. Who thought it was a good idea? Of course, there's no fucking ammo around here, for that matter, anyhow. Yeah, it hurts, right, doesn't it? Like the entire fucking section, because I have to replay this again. And this time around, we try to preserve the ammo at least from these people. And of course, we have unlimited ammo and unlimited grenades and unlimited everything. Yeah, yeah. Oh, right, so we can immediately restart the section yet again. So, case in point. This game in the later portions just, falls apart just a tiny bit if we're honest with ourselves, yes? Especially this fucking ghost back here respawning out of nothing. So fucking andere Leibe doing this in combat, you have no idea. Yeah, it's a long drop, also hurt. So, goodie, so it's down to you and me again. Friend, of course, we have to fight these fucking beings, because it's the only way to the satellite dish. Yeah, one grenade every single second here, what is that? Okay, so I have to do this shit yet again, or alternatively, we see what this is all about, because there is some, slightly yellow shit in here. Mm-hmm. And now what? Punch it, shoot it, what's the deal? Okay, so we just shoot it, I guess, but it works, I suppose. Alright, so what do we have to work with back here? A couple of items, and of course there's the yellow thingy, so we need to move that other thing over here as well. Well, that's nice. Maybe this time around we can die to a couple of these ghosts, maybe? Come on, Nick, what does it take? Why, oh why, do we have to do it like this, especially up the stairs? Because both items are absolutely necessary, we already know that. So, how are we dealing with these fucking creatures, because they're spawning in from behind as well, and I have no ammo to go around, I need more than 25 rounds to take care of business. Can we get more ammo anywhere? No is the answer, right? Probably, maybe there's some ammo downstairs, well, since we have to go that way anyhow. Of course, if we fail, it's all the way back to the checkpoint. Of course it slips off. Of course it would. Alright, let's just see if there's some ammo downstairs. We need at least a couple of magazines. And if we do this shit again here about the light form, why does it not fit in our inventory? The answer is because the game developers hate our guts, I guess. Okay, down here should be safe-ish, I hope at least. But is there some ammo around? Okay, a shotgun with 8 shells, and the shotgun is super slow to fire, and we also have to stand still while firing it from dip, because that seems sensible. But I suppose we did kill some people over here, so, yeah, okay, that's my magazine. Is that all we get back here? Apparently so. Yeah, goodie. Well, great. Well, it's better than having no spare magazine, but it's hardly ideal. So, we have to do this shit again. At least it is pretty obvious what we need to be doing. But sometimes, I mean, the slightly yellow cue there on the terrace was very hard to see, I would grant them that. So, okay, so there's still one of those things around. Once it senses our presence, we have like 5 of them, including people spawned behind us. That seems fair. Of course, I cannot shoot it if it's not revealed. Or decides to reveal itself, I should say. Okay, and now the door should open, but I cannot throw down a save file, so... Goodie. They will spawn in behind me, they are very, very dangerous. I cannot even attract his attention. That doesn't work, and it's not coming over here anyhow. And the door is already closed. Of course it is. What else? Running past there wouldn't make a difference, and of course if only barely over 50 rounds, man. What am I supposed to do here? The pistol? Okay. I don't think I can sneak past here. It didn't work in the past, and that's not going to change. The next room will probably contain more enemies. So we have to survive this. I said we have to survive this, Snake. We have to survive this. Okay, well, we survived. And now we have no ammo and also no health. But we can fix at least one of those problems. Good aim. Oh, delightful. But it seems to be the way to go. Of course, I can't read it on command. And Nick does it only when we run out of bullets, essentially. Or we have some time to reload for that matter. Okay, what's behind here? Danger. Wow, that doesn't look ominous at all. Oh, it's just... I'm getting discouraged here already. And of course the checkpoint is on the other side of the room where else for the B. And once I move out of the doorway, this fucking thing will also close, presumably behind me. Okay. Yeah, once again, I do have some questions about the later portions of the level here, or the game in general. Okay, well, how many will there be in here this time around? I can see two already, which means there will be multiplying by at least three. So then we try to be sneaky with our 26 bullets and no fucking checkpoint anywhere. And my new saving, of course, is too fancy, we can't have that. The door is still closed with great speed to trap you in this room, I think. Okay, where the heck are we even going for that matter? I see something up here. Nothing we can interact with. There's a door which is probably locked, I would figure. Right? Probably. Of course, there's no reason to assume I can sneak over there without being attacked by an entire horde. And with 26 bullets, it just ain't happening. Do you see any ammo around here? I certainly don't. I'm 100% certain this door will be locked. Probably. Of course it's locked. I need to clear these things, otherwise we cannot proceed, I just know it. We are aware of how the game works, yes, and of course the psi energy doesn't help me, I need ammo. I cannot TK them, I cannot throw items at them, I cannot set them alight, it doesn't work. Well, maybe this could work, I'm not quite sure. Maybe? Well, I cannot look at them through ghost vision and launch my fireballs at the same time because it doesn't work. But I think we have to interact with that thing over there somehow, which will of course also upset these creatures. This thing cannot be used in combat, of course, and we're down to one large medkit already. Maybe use ghost vision and punch the wall or shoot it or whatever. Maybe this could work, but I don't think it would be that easy. There must be a puzzle we need to be doing in this room. And to do the puzzle we need to kill all these creatures, which will be spawned behind us, no doubt. Oh. Yeah, I don't see a structural weakness, so that's not the way to do it. Okay, there is a yellow thingy. We put the stuff on the yellow thingy. Maybe? Ado, this is, of course, blue. This is red, and the other one is yellow, so we need to find a yellow object here in the room somewhere. Well, if there is a yellow object, it's probably going to be on the far side, because where else would it be? Of course, the footprints end right here. Oh, pressing the button, of course, doesn't do anything. Need to move an object up here. Something. Yeah, once they see me, I'm dead, essentially, that's the problem. Okay, red. Okay, so we need this thing in here as well, I think. So, where are we getting in object? Yellow one, I have no idea. Okay, now we need to move these fucking things inside. And then, the passageway will be revealed. I cannot assume that blue and yellow are compatible, but since there are only two objects in here, I guess. I don't think this would work, but okay. No, of course not. That's what I figured. But okay, there's the blue one. Okay, so the other side. That's a little bit hard to judge the distance. Nick, are you drunk? Yes, he must be drunk. There was no change whatsoever on control input, by the way, nothing. He's just drunk. So the controls are horribly broken in the PC version anyhow, we already know that, but still. Since I cannot use this in my inventory, I have to use physics for this. Okay, so, but it should be the right object at least, right? It's both blue, but where the heck are we getting a yellow object from? I have no idea. And this thing also needs to be moved inside somehow. Yeah, a yellow thing. A yellow object. I didn't see any yellow objects, by the way. And I think the red one was over there someplace, right on the far side of the room, because where else would it be? Of course, if we fail, we have to replay the entire section. Yellow objects probably contained up here, maybe. But this portion is starting to overstay its welcome due to the overall lethality of the enemies and the supply consumption as it is right now. Nope, it's still one over, of course. Oh, delightful. And this will open this section and then we can move through here, I guess. Is that the idea? It may be. It's nothing. No, 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 no. Okay, we survived. Good here. Oh, that's something. Okay, we're down to less than 30 rounds combined. Okay, so it is the correct object, yes? So it's red on red. So, what the heck are we doing now? Because there's one empty pedestal with a yellow object we have no access to, from the looks of it. Okay, so evidently the solution is pretty easy. It just requires me to move really close to these things, because otherwise I cannot differentiate the color. Yeah, so that's the problem, because the boards are indeed in the same room, so I was just overthinking matters essentially. And moving these pyramids in here was unnecessary, because they don't trigger the pedestal anyhow, I think. And... what? I do a nick all the time. Okay, that's a white one, I believe. So, maybe our pyramids aren't even broken here, so all this work was for nothing. Nicht in this room. Okay, whatever you do, wait for the checkpoint. Don't die. This is no pattern here whatsoever to this shit. Set it down. I know we love to play with these balls, Nick. No? Maybe Sarah also does, but in the moment we put it in here, please. Thank you very much. Alrighty, so this is now activated, so our pyramids don't even do anything. Oh, that's delightful. So I was just vastly overthinking matters by the looks of it. Okay. At least we found another magazine downstairs, you know. But we have to be really close, otherwise it's impossible to see the color of this object. Like, not really impossible. So this is blue, for instance. Yeah, so this doesn't work. I think you are yellow, but it's hard to tell. And why are we throwing these things all the time? I just don't get it. Yeah, why this hopefully the correct color. No, it's not. What is the color, man? It's so hard to tell. Is it not yellow? Certainly not the game made for the colorblind. Which I'm not, but it's too hard to see. Okay, so it's extremely finicky about this, so we have to be reliant on these puzzles then. Okay, so these pyramids don't do anything then, in this room at least, so they are different sockets. Oh, there's some advanced security system there. I think it may be blue. Hard to say, but I think it's blue. Okay, so wasting all of our supplies because Nick loves to play with his balls. There we have it. Okay. And we're doing all of this to get to the satellite dish there. Okay, wow, you've outlived your usefulness, I see. So we throw it all the way over there, because why not? So, now we just need the red ball. At least they are unbreakable. Unlike my will here, I guess. Set it in already. Come on, what does it take? Carefully, there we have it. A good idea. Certainly looks very impressive, and hopefully this will finally reveal the passageway as well as the checkpoint. Okay. Sure. Yes, it's pretty amazing, isn't it, Nick?
This is the place. The ancient monks worshipped a fragment of the monolith here. And like the monks, I have given up my physical existence to find the truth. I have become the true god of the ether.
You've entered RV permanently? Where's your body?
In a safe place. The general thinks that he's going to gain the power of a god. I already wield that power. This is my temple now. With my abilities, I see all and know all. I pierce the soul and control the mind. I control creatures from beyond our
dimension. Yes, roll your eyes. I have the same idea.
What are these abilities, if not the toys of a god?
Where's the general?
I will steal the power from him. He can't leave me behind to play god dog in his hour of glory. And that is why I need you.
Sure, just leave a friend for me to play with. Okay. Weit, wo ist der Checkpoint erschobst? I didn't get to notice. Okay, wow. So power makes him mad, especially side power, I would figure. And this evidently is the wrong way to go. But regardless, I'm expecting trouble and a few supplies. Oh, there's our checkpoint. Immediately there's some friends waiting, I see. What's that else? And triumphant music is playing, even though it's a little bit premature. I don't think stealth is going to work, and I only have 12 shots for the pistol remaining. Oh, hello there. Guess what that is? It's one with a sniper rifle, one of the super annoying night fellows. I don't think I would have any precision throwing a barrel against him. At least there was a checkpoint, so if we fail, then we can relax and try again. And later portions in this game are certainly not easy. Oh great. Of course it's a guy with a sniper rifle. Good, fantastic. Good, fantastic. So then we find this here regardless. Ah, did he come? Ah, whatever. Of course, doesn't make a difference. So I can shoot him from back here even though the aperture just came otherwise. Okay, a couple of cuts later and this guy with a fucking sniper rifle shot me through solid cover. But as it turns out, we can actually throw these rocks about. But of course, it is great we can't utilize because there's no finesse from back here. We have to be a lot closer than this. And then hope that the angle works for us. Which of course it won't. Oh, knocked some people over, I guess. Oh, enjoy that friend. I don't think this would work. Nope, of course it doesn't. Okay, and we're doing this to get to the satellite dish. Of course there will be even more people waiting. Keep this in front of us, Nick, please. This doesn't... whatever. And I can see even more snipers. Well, another sniper rifle would be nice. I think there's one of those downstairs, but these are unusable in this game, especially when under fire. And since these people cannot be affected by TKs, what guess I guess? How am I supposed to deal with that? Just walk up the ladder? I guess I don't have any other options. It's impossible, but of course they will shoot me in the back. Of course I'm helpless on the ladder. Maybe not. Well, that's amazing. Okay, maybe this time around it's a good idea because there's an other sniper over here, of course. Okay, crouch, take aim, and hope for the best. It's a matter of shooting in the head. There we have it. Oh, right. Yeah, the sniper rifle is unusable in combat. It's very, very situational on PC. So, anyone else around here? Sniper, scope, hello there, Nick. Thank you. I think it entirely depends on the positioning of Nick and also the barrel of the weapon. Okay, now there's a medkit on the wall. So, how many dudes are over here? And most importantly, how many people will be spawned in front of me or behind me once we get a little bit closer? Ah, who knows? Well, I don't see anyone else, so I guess the next reinforcements there will be... Oh, there's someone actually. Maybe we can still deal with him. Them. Once again, I can't look through my scope because I'm not sure there's no pattern here. So. The problem is that the weapon's way is like out of this world. No, of course it didn't. And Mr. Marksman can hit me from back here, no problem with the assault rifle, I guess. And I cannot retaliate in return. Oh, the light form. At least he doesn't have a sniper rifle. Yeah, the later portions of this game are hard to take seriously. And I'm not just referring to the plotline here. Man, get off the fucking ladder, you idiot. Of course, sandbags we can not throw, but these rocks we can throw. But of course, there could be some other enemies around here as well. Maybe not outside the temple, who knows? I wouldn't take anything for granted, though. I've only had some grenades, which of course we don't possess right now. But he saw that white. When I was crouched, I couldn't look through the sniper scope. It was impossible. And the setting myself down here means I could not hit him, because he's behind the sandbags. Ah, there's a medkit at least. Alright. Pretty resilient fellow, needless to say. Oh, then we see who else is waiting for us upstairs. Oh, we're giving these people rocket launchers now, and they're waiting, of course, right here. And I have 12 shots for a pistol, and that's about it right now. Oh, that's going to be a cakewalk, I'm sure. I mean, they said I can upset their balance by using multiple decay powers simultaneously, but this is impossible to do with the control scheme on PC, especially when rebinding these keys. But I think we knocked him down and we also set him alight at the same time because he can only defend against one ability at a time or something like that. That's maybe something we can rely on sometimes, but have like 10 shots for this thing, that's not going to be good enough. Yeah, I'm just wasting all my TK, I just noticed. So there's a severe penalty attached if you go for that. But good aim. I mean, TK powers are almost useless against them, from what I can tell, so... This is the rocket launcher. And of course also an unlimited supply of grenades and ammo, and supposedly also... Yeah, rockets. Sure. where are these even coming from? From the guy upstairs? No, this is another one stationed over here. Yeah, it's like one grenade every second, essentially. Okay, it's also one of those people. I don't know how to tell through the smoke and everything. Yeah, okay, I can't even target him, so what gives I guess? Okay, what am I supposed to do with 10 shots here for my rifle? And 12 shots for the pistol? Because supplies are so scarce all of a sudden. It's not that I can snipe them from back here, yeah? That's not going to happen. So, officially we are stuck already, I guess. Sure, sure, why not? Let's just fight that. Why we get knocked around by some fucking grenade. I think it was actually the rocket launcher. So once again, we can't look for the sniper scope from back here. I'm pressing the fucking button, it doesn't work. Doesn't work because the sniper rifle is unusable in combat. Case in point again. Good idea. Who knew this game would be so difficult all of a sudden because of the. I just can't look through the scope. Nick doesn't allow me to. That's the only angle from back here. So are we no scoping them? I suppose we try that. It's a waste of ammo. Probably now it works for whatever reason. Okay, I guess I take it. Okay, you're next in line, hopefully. Nee, go for the sniper scope, please. Nee, kein Lot hier. It just doesn't work. It just doesn't work. The mouse sensitivity is all over the place anyhow, but at least finally we can do this. Yes, crouch for better accuracy, because otherwise there is no accuracy. And that we have to keep a sharp beat with the rifle. Okay, there he is, but we have to make sure we can actually hit him. Because we only have a couple of bullets. Okay, so three sniper shots on target, no effect. Good. Okay, so one guy down. Three shots from a pistol, and of course Rocket Man is still down below here some players, watching and waiting. If only I could target the barrel maybe without dying. But it's not dead, of course, right? Oh, maybe it's dead. Okay, that's at least something, but I don't think we have access to specialty weapons in this game like at all. So the opposition has been silenced for the time being, although we have no supplies to go around, so that could be difficult. I can just rely on TK powers and the free shots with the pistol. Never mind all the medkits, you know. It's also a problem. Certainly things aren't getting any easier around here, wouldn't you think? I don't see any ammo or anything in between, and this guy of course didn't drop anything for us except for some side juice maybe. I suppose the rocket launcher is not usable because we don't have any heavy weapons training. Okay, is there anything of interest back here when it comes to breakable walls and whatnot? Since they taught us this ability, was actually heavily emphasized in the last section. Not right now, that's unfortunate. At least we have arrived at our destination. Like a glove. Like a glove. Well, good riddance, I'd say. Good fucking riddance.
The tower is clear. Meet me at the top. I found a laboratory.
Laboratory, they said. It's nice, but of course there will be some friends between us and the laboratory. I'm not quite sure how easy it will be with three pistol bullets, essentially. Normally I wouldn't be so persistent about these things, but since we need all the ammo because it's super essential at this stage of the campaign, we have to hope that we can get up here to get at least one magazine for our firearms and also that medkit I spotted. Okay, I can at least get that thing. Okay, we pick it up automatically, which is good. Okay, where's that rifle? Okay, wollen Baker sehen, if we're certainly above the trap room. And we can jump up here, because it's marked as inaccessible. And of course, we can jump on the watchtower. There's no middle position, because that would make some sense. So the other firearm is inaccessible for the rest of the universe, I guess. So there's our 4 damage, I was kind of concerned about. Okay, so 1 magazine for the assault rifle and 3 bullets for the pistol. What do you mean we can jump over here? Okay, so apparently then we have to use the stairs. Whatever. So, we're running around before a magazine against an unknown number of enemies who have respawned, no doubt. Oh, yes, okay, some point. Some with a rocket launcher someplace. Now with the dodge rockets, is it easier to dodge than sniper rifles? Oh, I mean, I should say 50 caliber slugs. I mean, there's another guy over here, why? That would fail because we can target something. So with unlimited ammo, we're shooting 1 rocket every single, second essentially. So, okay, 4 damage is preferable to this happening, I guess. Oh, good aim. He's immune to decay powers. Good, 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 good section. Alright then, friends, to cut a long story short, we just dodged the guy with the rocket launcher through some miracle, and of course now we have friends between us and the entrance to the tower everywhere. Yeah, and we have no supplies essentially. So, okay. So we have to use all of our abilities to the best of our abilities indeed, which is maybe not really easy to achieve. Of course, you can shoot me, but the barrel is actually pointing downward. Because this guy has no shame, and the game for that matter. Yeah, okay, hello there. Oh, just... No! Fuck off! Goddamn fuck off. And the guys of course have unlimited ammo, so they're set at least. But I think people will be in this room as well, because it already happened. And I think they also only spawned in. Right? After I moved down the stairs, because... Oh, actually they're still here. Already for that matter. And as you can see, we have friends, these elite goons everywhere. Okay, we managed to take out 1, which will help immensely, that's good. So, that's what I meant about using ability in a smart fashion. And our non-existent health, essentially. Okay, so wow, how difficult can it be, famous last words and all. I think we've run out of mind puppets and the other guy is invincible, of course. We have to storm into this room somehow. That's unfortunate, but at least it's one guy down already. Courtesy of our mind puppet. Meat puppet even. And the doors, they slam shut after a split second, which is always good. Yeah, good idea. The game really loves to spawn enemies relentlessly sometimes. Maybe it's been weakened slightly, that could be. Running against an entrenched enemy is usually a bad idea, but what can we do? There are no other options, I think. I cannot target anything Frobo from back here. I don't have any grenades. I cannot use the rocket launcher. So, watch your animal. And of course, you have no shame, you have no shame, game, nothing. You have no shame whatsoever, I'm sorry. The fault we dealt with the ghost problem, but apparently not. Oh, that's what I figured. Of course, there's still here. Alright, well, of course, we already know how the game ticks at this point in time. And now we have a full complement of rifle ammo, which of course is not enough to sustain us in any firefight, especially not in this game. Okay, making smart use of abilities is important, of course. But we're out of medkits and we're down to our last rejuvenator. This doesn't bode well. I would assume there is no shortage of enemies to shoot at. But okay. Of course, Ghost Vision drains the powers continuously. I can't really afford this. No handrails, but it's least of our worries. If I were the enemies, I would just throw down grenades here. But of course, I would do that anyhow, I think. Wow, that looks pretty nice. Is it the laboratory as decoded? I have no idea. Well, it doesn't tell me. We haven't arrived yet, evidently. Well, not, at least not really. Oh, that must be the laboratory they're talking about. Is there any turret here on the wall, maybe, or camera? Of course, our ghost cannot look up. The neck is just too stiff. But I really don't trust the comb here. But apparently it's also the end of the level, thankfully. Which took us way too long to clear because the game doesn't take reload attempts into consideration, I guess. And the assault rifle was the only firearm with some ammo, so... suicides cost. What does it mean? That's a new one, I think. Lots of property damage, then again, it's ancient technology. So who knows? We can put a price tag on that. Yes, I think it's a good idea. About to enter the laboratory we go, so which horrors are waiting for us now?
Nick, I'm trapped by these creatures. They're attuned to our individual brainwaves set up like watchdogs by Wrightson. It seems the movement set up a kill switch to protect themselves. It eradicates the creatures for a while. There's a control room past the lab. But you'll need to find the correct frequency for setting the switch. Look around for it.
So we didn't do anything, we divide. We just had a temporary respite here, so to speak. And of course the medkit is all the way back here. But it's essential because we have no medkits. Thankfully the rubber is movable. Even these T-beams. Yes. Of course, I had no input to actually throw this thing, just Nick doing his own stuff. There we have it. I would have hoped for more than this here, but of course, it isn't the case. Alright, so do we have any intelligence on this area whatsoever? Okay, another four areas. Maybe five, who knows ultimately, and this must be the location of the original artifact, I would figure. Maybe the monolith has to be placed in one specific spot, who knows. Map room, yeah, we need to find some sort of combination with our ghost vision, I think. Kill switch, wow. I would more than happy to oblige. So, will it be... Of course, yes, he likes to toy with us. I'm not quite sure what to expect anymore, friends. Nothing good, really. Hopefully they toned down some of the annoyances of the previous level. But they wouldn't bet on it. At least this being a Psy laboratory, there should be no shortage of Psy supplies. That was the last time we even managed to go for a stealth kill for that matter. I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. And the door will close, of course. Oh, okay, this one doesn't close so quickly, that's nice. So we can observe the enemies for a little bit while staying undetected. And then maybe throw one of those explosive canisters against them. Stealth isn't going to help us over here, I would think. Yeah, hello there and goodbye. And some free side juice for us. He finds that very suspicious, I see him. Need more than a medic once I'm done with you. Right? Okay, that's good. I do love laboratories more than I love ancient temples with ghosts and everything. So I do hope this will be slightly less annoying. There should be some spare rifle ammo once you have some time for that. So remember where it is, please. I'm sure he's giving us some helpful tips, like his confession of love for us. How nice of him. But I think we're into Sarah, yes? Although who knows, I'm not one to judge. A frequency they set. Well, we know where this thing is going. Guaranteed. Of course, we are expected, what else would be the case? Yes, maybe a meat puppet would be a good idea. Mind-controlled meat puppet even. Okay, this is the alert panel. Thankfully, it wasn't triggered, but then again, I don't think it would make much difference at all. So let's just try to throw that... Okay, can we try to throw that thing over here, maybe? Through the door, please, Nick. And of course not. We can throw an overdoor a couple of times. Now he's angry. Yeah, okay. I would throw some grenades around the corner if it was any reliable. I mean, them throwing grenades at me and then returning the favor, so to speak. That's difficult to achieve. I'm not sure that hit anything because there was no one screaming in pain. And there's also a selection of dudes around the corner. Right, there was a selection of dudes behind the corner. Of course he missed, and that's one of those idiots per side, but of course it would be. So he is slightly inconvenienced, but it's all that happened here. Good. I just don't have the accuracy from back here. So I don't think it can be resolved very easily, and of course I cannot mind control these people. That's also a thing. Is there anything else in the room we can throw? I don't think the chair would upset anyone. Even if the door were not to close all the time. I think he actually just destroyed the chair. Well, we can always throw these bodies, of course, once we're done with them. With the side juice drain. Okay, we took some fire, but at least he seems to be down. Yeah, we fought right over his head, I think. Oh, he was good at dodging, either of those things. Yeah, doing this in combat is so unreliable, but thankfully he was already down. And that's a high recharge point, I guess. Something about all personnel. Aha, oh, supervisor. I suppose we are operating alone, aren't we? Mhm. And they're working on some ancient artifacts. Thankfully there's some ammo in here. I'm not going to step on this, you know. Without any precautions, but someone was moving through here, evidently. That could be a clue. And the first aid station is always very important. Okay, what are we looking at? Some indecipherable artifacts, and I don't think we can just throw this into the... I guess we see what happens once we do that here. Probably only works on people with psi powers. Probably. Must be automated thingy. And this, of course, is shatterproof glass, as with most things here. Evidently, it's important, but for now, we see what's on the other side. This apparently is the beta lab. Okay, two regular, but I should say heavily armored goons, and otherwise I don't see anything of particular importance. But of course it can change, we need to find some combination, which is probably not achievable very easily for here. I do see the medkit. Uh-huh. We have to come through here anyhow to see our ghost vision. There's also an alert panel on the wall, presumably, since the layout is mirrored. Maybe if we can target the other guy, we can use some mind abilities, but if I don't have to use mind control, I'm not going to. Okay, whatever. Of course, I'm stuck because there are some corpses on the floor. I think they saw me because I was peeking around the corner. Something like that, presumably. What happens sometimes, of course. But now we can look for this area in peace, relatively speaking. So, what are we hiding in here? We need some key combination, of course. Maybe on one of those boards. 0746, okay. 0746. And that must be one of those monsters. Huh. Of course they are Lifo. Do they have a name for that matter? Apparently these have been encountered in the outback. China, South America and Antarctica apparently. Even though this one is crossed out. Undetectable. Most of the time, yes. And of course they are Lifo. The best combination. And something about failure, so they're trying to... is it the monolith? I think it is, right? I'm not sure what they were figuring out or trying to. Intermediate optical... No idea. Something like that. So it was certainly important coming in here. I suppose then there's only one way to proceed, a fully teleporter with some unknown outcome. Can't say I like that, but then again, what can we do? I don't think we have ventured into this area just yet. Okay, this, okay, this could be of interest. This area is slightly confusing, but I think these labs should be marked properly on the map here somewhere. Okay, so then we are moving through this hallway down to the control room, if you can make this happen. And then afterwards, I think it's down to the teleporter. Oh no. I'm also stuck behind the fucking crate, am I not? So I'm... Yeah, I enjoy that. Immediately with all these people on top of us. But supposedly I could have used my ghost vision, yes? I guess that the answer is to probably head for the teleporter and not worry about the other angle, because apparently it will be a repeat of the situation at the tower entrance, like these monsters respawning indefinitely for us, blocking our path. But I think we have to go in here again, because the code will have changed. I did confirm this by the way, in case you're wondering. Okay, some more friends waiting for us at the hallway, of course, since we already know that. Maybe this time around we can make it a little bit easier for us. Since there's so much psi power around, maybe we try to use our mind control abilities, but I don't think that's going to happen. It may have connected, I hope, but I'm not so sure. No, apparently not. Okay, okay, set it down carefully, please, Nick. If only these doors weren't shutting on us all the time. That was too short, or is he down already? No, of course it isn't. Yeah, of course he's invincible to that. That's what I figured. Not quite sure what type of combination they were talking about, because it's not very easy to pull off, as it would appear. Yeah, well, okay. I don't want to brute force my way through every single encounter if avoidable, but sometimes it's the only feasible way, I guess. There we have it, okay. Hopefully that's the trick for a little bit. Yeah, there was some propane tank over here, I think. Too funny, when it works, of course. Interesting. Well, I don't hate the game, but sometimes these later levels that do get on my nerves just a tiny bit, if I'm honest here, right? Okay, so we have to access the Psy area then, presumably because this is a death zone, even without physics interactions. So let's just retrieve the code once again, see if we can do, because I'm pretty certain. Yeah, I didn't prompt you to climb this, by the way. What? Okay, I guess the angle just works for them, for whatever reason. Wasn't that great? Oh, must have been something explosive in here. Oh, nice of us. And I didn't even see that medkit last time around, so good thing we had to reload, I guess. Nee, get this thing off the way, thank you very much. Excellent, because it could be useful. Another medkit. This is a smaller variety, unfortunately, so. Not right. I guess then we see, but I do believe these codes, they do change. Yeah. Okay, now it's 3804. And this, of course, is entirely by design, so if you die, you have to replay all these rooms, of course. Something to keep in mind for later. This will only be valid until we have to reload or pass to the next checkpoint, assumedly so. Okay, so since the other area is off limit, then we have to hope for the best and go for the teleporter. Although I really think it would lead to the excavation site and not the command room, but apparently I'm mistaken. I don't want to suffer any problems any longer here with this physics engine puzzle, so let's just move this thing out of the way so we can move freely in case we have to next time around. Okay, so what are you showing us? Where are we even? I'm not sure. Where did you come from? Why we are in a different area? I don't have any idea, frankly. But apparently you're of importance somehow. So you have to input the code for us, I see. Maybe. This door doesn't open. Apparently you have unlimited psi control in here. That's interesting. Of course it doesn't make sense when you think about it, because I'm standing right on this panel, so it's not a teleporter. It's a regeneration device for experimentation purposes and whatnot. Yeah, I think we have to override the lockdown someplace, I would assume, to get access to the control room. Or maybe not. Okay, interesting. 4 minutes. Okay, what are we going to do in 4 minutes? I'm not sure. please tell us. What's the deal here? The map room. Okay, if I do remember where the map room is for that matter. Because the clock is ticking down and we can only disable these beings for a limited duration of time as it was pointed out in the cutscene. Okay, through the door and then to the right, and I do believe the door was locked the last time we tried, so we have to figure out how to unlock it, I guess. Warum doing this in a pinch is not going to be easy. We just came through here, there was no one around. Oh, wow, this game is no shame, what can I say, really? Okay, wow, what can I do, man? Give me a mind puppet? No, of course, it's all elite goons around here. I don't think we will be arriving in 3 minutes time then, presumably. Oh, they're throwing the last reserves against me, I guess. Somebody does. And what happened here? I beg your pardon? Fuck's sake. Open that goddamn door, you idiot. May just be infinite respawning, who knows, at this point in time, anything is possible in this game. So I just try to make a run for it to the map room, made up of Sarah. The door is not locked, surprisingly. Okay, wow, no one is following us, I'm hoping. That's our objective, so to speak.
This data vault stores everything Wrights and spies on.
The moon? But Luna 1 was retrieved in the late 60s.
Doing a little homework, sis? Tanya?
Your sister?
Nice to see you again.
Ah, so I was correct all along. Who knew?
I've been searching for you. Of course. The general had me go into hiding to draw you to him. He used you to keep tabs on Mindgate. After our parents died, we only had each other. How could you betray me for the general? It was because our parents died that we were taken in by Mindgate. I wanted that to happen. Our parents would have never let us harness our true power. I killed them to ensure our future. No.
Yeah, psi powers make people mad. Insane, even.
Ready to play?
Sarah!
The final phase draws near.
Follow me if you want to save Sarah.
Of course, of course, on the same timer. Okay, goody, so what are we doing now? We're trying to, of course, get to the other area, then I would assume. We need now, in a chamber. Okay, well, it's not a teleporter, because it's not a teleporter. I guess we have to fight our way through all these goons, then get to the back side of the room somehow. Okay, it's going to be a cakewalk, I'm sure. Why, we can only prepare ourselves and hope for the best. We only have a couple of minutes remaining. Who knows what's going to happen? Probably it's not going to open for us very easily. Why wouldn't you think? Probably not. Nope, it's locked. It's locked. Of course, as usual, we have people spawning behind us. Of course, okay, give me some juice here, please, even though it's hardly any time to stop. 2 minutes and ticking down, so there must be a control panel here someplace. Maybe you can do it for us, sir. Maybe that's how we're going to do it here, okay. We don't have time for this. Of course, it's a 2-checkpoint affair. Yeah, it hurts, right? That's what I figured, but we're full on health right now, so I don't think we need to worry about this tiny pickup. Checkpoint reached, and that's off to the excavation site, I believe.
<Damn it. laughs>
Ich glaube, was verwehrst du, ja?
And using your body to take the monolith for myself.
You're insane.
Everyone is. Everyone with mind powers. Okay, so, I suppose. In a boss battle right of the battle. Okay, so what I'm supposed to do this time around? Defeat the enemy certainly, but otherwise. I'm not so sure. Oh, But I suppose all we can do for today, so as usual, I think of watching and I hope to see you next time.